policies announced, these are some of the policy rates that are actually awaited because they influence the supply of money in the economy. So let us have a look at what do we mean by repo rate and reverse repo rate. So repo, reverse repo actually stands for repurchase agreement. So here in repo rate, repo is repurchase, which implies that reverse repo is reverse repurchase agreement. Now, when the commercial banks, they need funds, they are falling short of funds, then they can approach RBI for borrowing. Now, this borrowing, like any other borrowing, is taking place against a collateral. So, RBI is asking for securities from the commercial bank before it is lending the money to commercial bank. Those securities are in two forms, generally in form of GSEC, which is government securities, and T-bills, which are your treasury bills. So this kind of collateral is furnished by the commercial bank with RBI, and then RBI lends money to the commercial bank as per the duration for which it is required. At the end of the duration of the agreement, the commercial bank will go back to RBI, will pay the principal amount to repurchase the securities, and will pay the repo rate of interest. So, with the payment of the interest plus the principal amount, the repurchase agreement comes to an end and the securities are transferred back to the commercial bank. A repurchasing agreement is signed by both the parties, here one commercial bank and RBI, stating that the securities will be repurchased on a given date at a predetermined price. So, very simple example, let us assume the repo rate fixed by RBI is 4%, which is the rate right now, and the amount borrowed by a commercial bank from RBI is rupees 10,000. Now, for this borrowing per annum, how much interest rate has to be paid? That will be rupees 400, that is 4% of 10,000 rupees. Obviously, if the borrowing is for a shorter duration, you accordingly adjust the rate of interest. Agar 6 months ki borrowing hai, to 200 rupees ka interest pay karega commercial bank to RBI. Now, repo rate is fixed and monitored by RBI. Keeping in mind how is the inflation in the economy, what is the money supply and other factors. Now, it proves beneficial for commercial banks if they are facing some short-term financial crisis, they can approach RBI for borrowing. When we move to the reverse of this, reverse repurchase agreement takes place at the reverse repo rate. Now, reverse repo rate can be interpreted in two ways. So, first, it is the rate at which RBI is borrowing from commercial banks. Okay, you can interpret it in this sense that RBI is borrowing funds from commercial banks and the rate of interest paid against this borrowing by RBI to commercial banks is the reverse repo rate. Another way of interpreting reverse repo rate is that when commercial banks have excess funds with them. Excess funds, I mean funds over and above their requirements, policy requirements, CRR, SLR, meet kar liya. एक आइडिया ले लिया कि कितने हमने लोन्स देने और उसके बाद भी आपके पास एक्सेस फंड्स हैं, देन रिवर्स रेपो रेट इज यूज्ड. by commercial banks to park their excess funds with RBI. Instead of lending money to customers, investors, institutions in the market, a commercial bank might feel कि इनको एक्स्ट्रा लोन देने से अच्छा है कि आरबीआई के पास अपना एक्स्ट्रा पैसा जमा कर दें और उस पे कुछ रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट अर्न कर ले, क्योंकि इन एनी केस आरबीआई इज अ सेफर ऑप्शन देन गिविंग लोन टू एक्स वाई जी इन द मार्केट. सो द रेट एट विच कमर्शियल बैंक्स कीप देयर मनी विद आरबीआई is the reverse repo rate. Let's take an example. If the reverse repo rate is fixed by RBI at 3.35% per annum, which again is the current rate of reverse repo, and the commercial bank is putting 10,000 rupees into RBI's account, then the bank will be receiving interest at the rate rupees 335 per annum. Now this rate is used actually to control the supply of money in the economy. Together, repo and reverse repo rate are part of the liquidity adjustment facility under the monetary policy. Because both these rates are actually being used to control the supply of money in the economy. If you have a look at the highlighted point, it is repo rate which is injecting liquidity into the system, kyunki commercial banks ke paas paisa aa raha hai aur wo paisa aage kahan use hoga, loans dene ke liye. To repo rate jab bhi use hota hai, repurchase agreement jab bhi use hota hai, it leads to an increase of flow of funds in the economy. On the other hand, reverse repo agreement, what is it doing? It is parking more funds with RBI, so there is less supply of money in the economy. क्योंकि अगर बैंक्स अपना एक्सेस पैसा आरबीआई के पास पार्क कर रहे हैं तो वो कम लोन दे रहे हैं जनरल पब्लिक को, तो इससे लिक्विडिटी क्या होती है, एब्जॉर्ब हो जाती है. सो दे आर वर्किंग इन टू ऑपोजिट डायरेक्शंस. व्हाट आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड हैज बीन समराइज्ड इन दिस ग्राफिकल प्रेजेंटेशन. सो व्हेन रेपो इज इंजेक्टिंग लिक्विडिटी, absorption of liquidity is taking place through reverse repo. Then coming to the difference in tabular form, it is there on your screens. Repo rate is higher than the reverse repo rate. Purpose of both the agreements is different. Repo is to get funds to increase liquidity, to meet the deficiency of funds, while reverse repo is to absorb liquidity, control the money supply in the economy. Just have a look at the points if there's any point which needs further explanation. Also have a look here. Any question? Okay, so what we get to know is that all these instruments, especially money market per se, there is a lot of scope for RBI in the money market, through the money market, to influence the working of the Indian financial system. Also, it is through the monetary policy that RBI is playing a prominent role in the money market by fixing the policy rates and the reserve rates. Now, policy rates are two, रेपो एंड रिवर्स रेपो. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट, जो आपकी बैंक रेट होता है, मार्जिनल स्टैंडिंग फैसिलिटी होती है, ये सब पॉलिसी रेट्स में आता है. आपके रिजर्व रेट्स में CRR और SLR आता है. सो वी आर फोकसिंग ऑन दीज फोर रेट्स. सो ऑल दिस इज इंटीग्रल पार्ट ऑफ द मॉनिटरी पॉलिसी टू चेक द मनी सप्लाई इन द इकोनॉमी. Okay, with this, the money market segment is done. Now we come to the capital market segment of the financial markets. So, coming to capital market, as discussed multiple times, it is the market for making long-term investments and ensuring the flow of funds from the surplus units to the deficit units. Now, for every economy, capital market is very important because with its various segments, it is actually ensuring the growth because it is channelizing the savings into investment. So, if I talk about capital market, we talk about two segments of the capital market. One is the primary segment and one is the secondary segment of the market. नाउ मनी मार्केट जो हमने डिस्कस करा था, वहां पर भी प्राइमरी और सेकेंडरी सेगमेंट होता है, पर जो इंडियन मार्केट है वहां पर मनी मार्केट स्पेसिफिकली प्राइमरी सेगमेंट इज मोर एक्टिव. बट इफ आई कम टू दी कैपिटल मार्केट, बोथ दी सेगमेंट्स, प्राइमरी एंड सेकेंडरी सेगमेंट ऑफ दी कैपिटल मार्केट आर क्वाइट एक्टिव. और प्राइमरी सेगमेंट तो हमने लास्ट ईयर में वी हैव सीन मल्टीपल IPOs, इनिशियल पब्लिक ऑफरिंग्स. सो दैट हैज बीन क्वाइट एक्टिव इन द लास्ट फाइनेंशियल ईयर. सो फर्स्ट, कैन एनीवन टेल मी व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन प्राइमरी मार्केट एंड सेकेंडरी मार्केट?
प्राइमरी मार्केट में न्यू सिक्योरिटीज ली जाती है
हाँ
एंड सेकेंडरी में उन्हीं को ट्रेड किया जाता है।
हाँ एब्सोल्युटली राइट चिराग. सो प्राइमरी मार्केट इज द मार्केट इन विच दी सिक्योरिटीज आर इशूड फॉर द वेरी फर्स्ट टाइम, एंड देन इट इज इन दी सेकेंडरी मार्केट दैट देयर सब्सिक्वेंट ट्रेडिंग टेक्स प्लेस. सो लेट्स हैव एन ओवरव्यू ऑफ द वर्किंग ऑफ द प्राइमरी एंड सेकेंडरी मार्केट्स इन इंडिया. So, as you can see on the slide before you, primary markets are the markets through which companies are raising funds to finance their projects. Now, there are a number of ways in which the primary market issue can be done. You are issuing fresh shares or preference shares or debentures, and one of the mechanism is also depository receipts. Now, when a company is approaching the primary market, it may have certain objectives in mind. And as you can see, those objectives can be to promote a new company. New companies का मतलब ये है कि से subsidiary launch कर रहे हैं अपने अंडर, to expand an existing company, to diversify the production, मीट दी वर्किंग कैपिटल रिक्वायरमेंट्स और कैपिटलाइजेशन ऑफ रिजर्व्स. सो प्राइमरी सेगमेंट ऑफ द मार्केट इज एंश्योरिंग अ फेयर मार्केट, अ फेयर प्लेस where the fund requirements of the corporates or of the government can be met. So when I talk about primary market, we need to talk about the IPOs, initial public offering, when the shares are offered to the public for the very first time. Now, this is a very, very crucial step for a firm, and it is a very complex step also. Rarely do we find firms that are handling the IPO on their own. They generally appoint merchant bankers, big financial institutions, to help them in the task of issuing an IPO. So a merchant banker is basically a bank which is offering you multitudes of services like portfolio management, IPO mein assist karna. Ye sab functions aapka merchant bank perform karta hai. Merchant banks, one or multiple merchant banks might help the issuer. Issuer is the company which is making the issue of shares in the market. If the IPO is handled properly, you are getting a good response from the market, then to a large extent, it ensures the viability of the share in the future. It ensures the success of that share in the future. Ab IPO itself, as I told you, it's a very complex process. There are number of parties involved which are assisting the company in the issuance of shares. Kyunki aap dekho, aapne scratch se shuru karna hai. Company ko pehle kitne shares offer karne hai, kitni amount honi chahiye shares ki, किस टाइम पे आईपीओ लॉन्च होना चाहिए, क्या टर्म्स होने चाहिए आईपीओ के, प्रोस्पेक्टस फाइल करना होता है, तो बहुत सारे स्टेप्स इन्वॉल्व हैं. तो हर स्टेप पे इट इज द मर्चेंट बैंकर हु हैज बीन आउटसोर्स्ड दिस जॉब ऑफ हैंडलिंग द इशू. ओके, सो बिफोर वी प्रोसीड टू हाउ आईपीओज एक्चुअली टेक प्लेस, let us understand who are the parties involved in the IPOs. First and foremost is the lead manager, jo head hoga pura IPO handle karne ka, independent financial institution who has been appointed by the company to manage the entire issue. Now, lead managers have multiple tasks with them. Right from drafting a prospectus. Can anyone tell me what is a prospectus? Yes, what is a prospectus, class?
Ma'am, we can say it is an invitation to the public to buy the shares.
Very good. Aap company law padh chuke ho?
Yes, ma'am. Corporate law.
Haan. So that is actually the definition quoted. It is the invitation by the company to the public to subscribe to the shares of the company. Yes, Chirag, you have something to add?
Yes, ma'am. Ye public company ke liye hota hai na, sir.
Beta, public ho jati hai company post IPO.
Okay.
ठीक है, तो private companies जो हैं वो IPOs या और भी मेथड्स होते हैं जिसके थ्रू शेयर्स लिस्ट करवाती हैं, और एक बारी शेयर पब्लिकली डिस्ट्रीब्यूट हो जाता है या पब्लिक उसमें इन्वेस्ट कर देती है, तो कंपनी प्राइवेट लिमिटेड से पब्लिक लिमिटेड बन जाती है. तो जैसे अब हम अपने बजट की बात कर रहे थे, तो बजट में LIC विल बी लिस्टेड और डिसइन्वेस्टेड, तो अभी तक LIC in that sense is a private company. Once the shares of LIC get listed on the stock exchange, it will become a public limited company. Okay. So prospectus gives all the details related to the issue. अब उसमें क्या क्या मेंशन्ड होता है, कंपनी क्या है, कब इनकॉर्पोरेट हुई, कंपनी का कोर बिजनेस क्या है, कंपनी का ऑब्जेक्टिव क्या है पैसा रेस करने का, और कंपनी के फ्यूचर प्रोस्पेक्ट्स क्या है, वो सब आपके प्रोस्पेक्टस में मेंशन्ड होते हैं. दिस इज डिजाइंड बाय द लीड मैनेजर इन कंसल्टेशन विद द कंपनी. So if I name some of the merchant bankers in India, aapka Bajaj Capital, Reliance Securities, Yes Bank, ICICI Securities, JP Morgan, Merrill Lynch, ye sab aapke Morgan Stanley, all these are merchant bankers. Citigroup, Bank of America, all these are some of the famous merchant bankers in the market. Okay. Apart from drafting the prospectus, what is a merchant banker doing? They are also helping in preparation of the budget of expenses. Now, there are number of requirements, steps that need to be followed. And obviously, at each step, expenditure is being incurred that needs to be managed by the company in consultation with the lead manager. Then what is the appropriate time for the issue? Very important, timing bahut important hai. Bahut bari companies ek ek saal tak hold pe rakhti hain IPO ko. Just keeping in mind what is the situation in the market, in the economy, और क्या एक्सपेक्टेशन है, क्या परसेप्शन है कंपनी की इन द आईज ऑफ द प्रोस्पेक्टिव इन्वेस्टर, इन द आईज ऑफ द पब्लिक. सो ऑल दीज फैक्टर्स दे इन्फ्लुएंस द टाइमिंग ऑफ इशू. बिकॉज अगर मिनिमम सब्सक्रिप्शन नहीं मिलता तो फिर कंपनी आगे शेयर्स अलॉट भी नहीं कर सकती. हाउ मच इज द मिनिमम सब्सक्रिप्शन? How much is the minimum subscription?
90% of the
90% yes of the value of the issue. So, agar 1 lakh ke shares issue karne hai, to kam se kam 90,000 shares worth ₹90,000 unke liye application aani chahiye company ke paas. Only then can it proceed with the issue. So, haan ji Chirag bolo.
Application pe 90% aani chahiye.
किस पे?
आप कह रहे हो कि 90% एप्लीकेशन पे आनी चाहिए.
तो 90% एप्लीकेशन आनी चाहिए ऑफ द टोटल वैल्यू यू आर टारगेटिंग थ्रू आईपीओ. तो अगर आईपीओ में मैं 1 लाख रुपीज के शेयर्स ला रही हूँ तो कम से कम 90,000 के शेयर्स के लिए एप्लीकेशन आनी चाहिए.
ओके.
उसमें भी अब कंपनीज बहुत सेफ प्ले करती हैं. कंपनीज अंडरराइटर्स अपॉइंट करती हैं जो कि इंश्योर करते हैं कि अगर 90% से कम आई एप्लीकेशन तो बची हुई एप्लीकेशंस, बचा हुआ जो मार्जिन है वो शेयर्स अंडरराइटर ही परचेज कर लेते हैं. ठीक है, वो मैं अभी आगे आपको डिटेल में बताऊंगी. Then assisting in marketing the public issue, you decide on the timings, then you are taking the help of advertising agencies to market the issue, and you are also appointing the other parties to the issue. So company and lead manager together are making or performing all these functions. So I've already given you a number of examples for foreign merchant bankers and for your domestic merchant bankers. Second is the second party involved in IPO is registrar to the issue. Now registrar is an institution, a bank or a trust company which is responsible for keeping the entire record of shareholders when an issuer sells security to the public. So not only will they maintain a record, they will also help in allotting the share certificates and maintaining all the paper trail, entire paper trail of the share allotment process. Now they retain the records at least for a period of 6 months from the allotment of the shares. Because if there's any question which any regulatory authority has with respect to the issue, then all this information is available with the registrar. Then I used a term underwriter. Now, underwriter are generally the merchant bankers or institutions which guarantee the success of the IPO. So, if there's any shortfall in minimum subscription, then it is met by the underwriter. They give an assurance to the issuer that the allotment, that the IPO will be a success, that they would subscribe to the securities if subscription limit is not reached. And what is the underwriting getting in return? They are getting commission, or depending on the terms of agreement, they might also be allotted a certain percentage of the shares of the company. They do not buy and sell securities in their own name. They are supporters, backup supporters, and are actually just providing a kind of insurance to the company that we will not let your IPO fail. So institutional underwriters भी हो सकते हैं. जनरली जो आपके कमर्शियल बैंक्स हैं वो एक्ट करते हैं अंडरराइटर, और योर डेवलपमेंट बैंक्स आल्सो. सो अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट यू हैव बैंकर्स टू द इशू. नाउ जो भी एप्लीकेशन मनी आता है कंपनी के पास, इट नीड्स टू बी केप्ट इन अ सेपरेट बैंक अकाउंट. इट कैन नॉट बी टेकन इन द नेम ऑफ द कंपनी. तो कंपनी के अपने अकाउंट में वो पैसा डिपॉजिट नहीं हो सकता. इन द नेम ऑफ दिस आईपीओ अ सेपरेट बैंक अकाउंट इज मेंटेन्ड. जब अलॉटमेंट होती है तो कंपनी को जो सक्सेसफुल एप्लीकेंट्स हैं उनको शेयर्स अलॉट करती है. वो लोग, वो पार्टीज जिनको शेयर्स नहीं मिल सकते, दे विल बी रिटर्न बैक देयर एप्लीकेशन मनी. और अगर कंपनी डीले करती है बियॉन्ड अ सब्सक्राइब टाइम लिमिट, देन पेनल्टी नीड्स टू बी पेड बाय दी कंपनी. तो कंपनी फिर इंटरेस्ट पे करती है. अगर विद इन टाइम फ्रेम अनसक्सेसफुल एप्लीकेंट्स का एप्लीकेशन मनी रिटर्न नहीं होता. सो बैंकर टू द इशू विल बी द बैंक वेयर एप्लीकेशन मनी इज बीइंग डिपॉजिटेड. दे आर एक्चुअली रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर कलेक्टिंग द एप्लीकेशन मनी एंड दे चार्ज कमीशन फॉर द सेम. एनी अदर फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशन माइट बी असिस्टिंग इन अदर रोल्स टू द कंपनी. दे माइट प्रोवाइड असिस्टेंस एंड एडवर्टाइजिंग एजेंट्स. दे आर मार्केटिंग द इशू. दे आर ब्रिंगिंग इट टू द नोटिस ऑफ द पब्लिक. हाउ एंड वेन कैन द पब्लिक सब्सक्राइब टू द शेयर्स ऑफ द कंपनी. सो दीज वर द पार्टीज विच आर इन्वॉल्व इन द आई